Swift. Everybody, welcome to the world of exquisite glam, brought to you by Miss Panama Tickness. Here is where we discuss all things beauty, makeup reviews, and how-tos. I'm your host, Miss Panama Tickness, and today's guest of honor is my cousin, the one and only Damo. For the fellas, represent for the fellas in the forum for tonight.
For the fellas, I got y'all, man.
Tonight's discussion will be on men and their views on makeup application and the women who wear them. So, we have a list of questions, and my cousin's going to ask these certain questions. And, of course, the ladies, I'm going to be representing for y'all for the answers. So, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Let's do this.
Okay. So, do you like to see women apply makeup?
I don't really care for it. You know, I don't really care for, you know, the makeup. I don't like the... Like, you mean if I was sitting there watching them apply it?
No, like, I'm saying when the application is already there, like, they faces beat.
Oh, and they faces beat?
Yes, they on fleek walking outside.
Eyebrows on fleek? Nah, I mean, I don't really like the makeup scene. Like, I like natural beauty. That's what I'm all about.
What's natural beauty to you?
Natural beauty is when they don't got the cake face. You know, they looking like a clown out there.
Can you tell the difference?
Now, see... We done had this discussion in the past, you know, and, you know, I had a person that tells me that I don't know how to tell the difference. And you've actually told me too. So, no, sometimes I can't tell the difference. Sometimes I can't.
All right. We could go through a trial and error right now to see if you know the difference between who has a cake face and who has a natural face. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. So who's more popular? Oh, America's Next Top Model, Miss Tyra Banks herself.
She's a top model. She already sound like she wearing a boatload of makeup.
But when you see her...
Boatloads.
When you see her on TV, do you think she has a natural face? Or she has a little bit of makeup or a full face of makeup?
Nah, I think she has a full face of makeup. Because I've seen some pictures of her natural and I'll be like... Is that still Tyra Banks? Like, what is that?
All right. Let's see. Who else do I know that wears makeup all the time? All right. Ratchet TV. Them girls that be on Ratchet TV. You know, the Love & Hip Hop scene.
Yeah. I'm not a huge fan of the Love & Hip Hop, but I do tune in sometimes here and there. But all them girls look like they be kicking their face up, man. They look like they be putting boatloads.
Boatloads? Yeah. Okay, what's a boatload to you? What's much makeup?
Man, when they out there looking like a zombie, man. Like, it's like the face, like they face is not matching their skin. They look like a bunch of powder on their face.
Okay, there's little things that you could do that may look like it's powder on their face, but it's really not that much powder. It's called setting powder. Like, if you take a picture of somebody that has on makeup.
Right.
And you look at the...
Yeah, you were telling me about that.
Yeah, you look at the flashback and you like, why does her face look kind of ashy? That's because she put too much setting powder on her face.
Right.
So that's why you see certain people that look like, okay, it looks kind of cakey. It's not flat. It's not blending in well. All of that. That's what you see. You actually see the setting powder. You really don't see nothing else. So that's probably what you have a problem with. Or it could be too much highlight. That could be it too.
That too.
Do you know the difference between highlight and contour?
No. I don't know nothing.
All right. Highlight is supposed to accentuate your features on your face. And contour is to hide the features on your face. Like
the bumps and the pimples
That. That's what foundation and concealer is for.
Because, you know, sometimes they be... When they be putting the makeup on, I could still see them bumps. I'd be like...
That's because you're supposed to take care of your skin
right
before you apply your makeup.
Take care of your skin and you don't need no makeup.
But listen, we trying to be on fleek 24/7. because we noticed that guys go for girls that are completely made up. Nobody likes natural beauty anymore. I mean, let me not say that. There's a few people that like natural beauty. There's a few.
Be me, myself.
There's a few. There's very few. I say out of 100 men, there's probably 10 men that'll go for natural beauty. The other 90, they want botched Barbies.
I mean, because, you know, men, we usually, you know, we... It's a lust of the eyes thing with us, man. So, you know, we see something we like.
But do you realize that 95% of what y'all like is made up? It's not really...
But it's all fake, though. Like, when you wash it off, then we like, ugh.
What you mean, ugh? That's what you wanted, though.
Huh?
That's what you wanted.
No, we thought that was how... I mean, yo, man, that makeup be fooling us sometimes. Me and myself, I be fooled because you put me on. You put me on to what the full face is and what's the other...
Half a face.
Half a face and all that. Like, and then some girls, I'd be like, damn, she had on all that makeup? I didn't even know. But, you know, it's just with some girls, I feel like with some girls, you like even when they have a full face of makeup, you can still tell, like, I guess with the features or whatever, they're pretty without the makeup.
Mm-hmm.
For yourself, mm-hmm. you look like... I mean... You're pretty without makeup,
mm-hmm.
of course. But, you know, sometimes the makeup, you know, it fools us sometimes.
I don't think it fools anybody. You know what I think it is? I think it's because a lot of people now, which I'm noticing, is that some people never used to like makeup. Like, for me, for instance. Like, right. You remember when we was younger? We used to hate watching grandma put on makeup. Like, it'll take her 40 years to put on some makeup. I used to hate it when I was younger. Now, look at me now. I'm older. Yeah. I like makeup. I'm a makeup artist. This is all I think about. This is all I dream about. I want it to be a business.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just certain people apply makeup either the wrong way or they... do overboard.
Like, we'll be killing maybe some dark skin girls that be putting on makeup.
But
like,
you know, that's...
How you looking brown skin now? Like, what the
but
hell?
That's the thing. That's the problem. There's not a lot of companies that help dark skin women. Mm. Especially, like, if you're, like, heavily melanated.
Even the light skin women, too. Like, they be looking extra light when they apply all that makeup on.
Listen, there's certain companies, I'm not even gonna give them a shout out because they're not sending me no residual check.
That's
but there's a lot of companies that do not help dark skin women, especially not even say dark skin women. They don't even help black women or Latin women of color, basically. Because
right.
I realized, let me tell you this experience I had one time when I went to Ulta. Of course, Ulta is not really in New York City area, but it's outside of that. Ulta is like the Sephora and the Max and mm-hmm. stuff like that. So I went into Ulta. I went for a specific shade of foundation because I know my shade.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not too red. I'm not too orange. I'm in the middle.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Speaking of orange, some of them be looking like Oompa Loompas out there. I'd be like...
Trump's daughter.
Girl, where you going?
Listen... I went in there. The lady was telling me, okay, we have a certain foundation for you that we could use from this specific company. And I told her, I don't want that because I already know what company I want. I know what specific color I need. And that's what I want. She's like, no. You could try it. Just try it. I think this blends perfectly well with you.
Mm.
So I'm like, okay, let's go try it. This will let her feel good because she's probably had to sell that certain product for the day.
Mm-hmm.
So I went, tried it on me. I look so dark. I thought I was growing another head on the side of my face. I'm like, what is this? You use this in the summertime when we having, you know, when the sun hit us and we get a little tan. That's what I would use that for. I wouldn't use that for me on a regular day.
Mm.
She's like, no, it blends in perfectly. I'm like, lady, no, it don't. You know damn well this does not look good on me.
Mm-mm.
It's like people need to learn their foundation. I think that's the next problem that a lot of guys are starting to pick up on. They see when girls don't blend their makeup properly.
Yeah,
and they see when the foundation doesn't really look
good thing to look at.
What? They see the foundation is not blending in. Like, I've heard so many complaints by guys saying that, okay, her shorty makeup is all right. It looks good, but her face and her neck is two different colors.
Right.
what?
Why is that?
Exactly. That's because her foundation or maybe her concealer that she used is way too light. And she didn't blend it in properly.
Mm. Another thing is the eyebrows.
Listen, I fall slave to the eyebrows. I'm not going nowhere unless my eyebrows is extra crispy. When I say it have to be on fleek.
I'm talking about some girls' eyebrows. They be across, they be all the way to the air. I be like, girl, where? It be looking like the American Eagle sign. I be like, oh, where you going with that? Like,
I've heard complaints about that too. I was saying that a lot of people, all right, I'm not even going to lie. I've learned how to do makeup through YouTube. Mm. Looking at different makeup artists on YouTube, how to do makeup. The first thing I learned how to do was my eyebrows. Mm. And at first, I'm not even going to lie. It's a trial and error thing. So you have to figure out.
Yeah, of course, you know, after a while you perfect it, then you'll get the hang of it.
Exactly. Right? You have to figure out your eyebrow shade. If you don't know your eyebrow shade, it's supposed to be the same color that's on your hair.
So could that be what it is when we see some girls with, you know, too much makeup on or whatever and be like, ugh. It's probably their first couple of times trying it out or something?
It's probably their first trial and error. They're trying to get used to whatever. And then you have these girls. You know, we live in Brooklyn, so everybody have like 40 different shades of hair color. Mm. So your eyebrows is supposed to be the same color as your hair.
Right. So some girls be having blonde hair with purple eyebrows.
Listen, like, it ain't supposed to be like that. If you have blonde hair, your eyebrows should be at least a light brown. Mm. Not so dark, not so black, not so whatever. That's one thing you shouldn't have is black eyebrows.
Right.
It should not be jet black like you shaded it in with a Sharpie pencil. Mm. Walking around like a, you know how cholas have that thin eyebrow and it look like they applied it with like this Sharpie marker.
Like the eyebrow game is just it's just crazy now because back in the days, chicks was cutting off their eyebrows and drawing them in. Now they
when
want eyebrows.
When we was
eyebrows.
In high school, we used to do that. Go right to the nail salon, let them shave it eyebrow pencil thin, thinking that it was cute.
No, that definitely wasn't cute. It wasn't cute.
I thought it was cute back in the day. I'm not even gonna lie.
Like,
I fall victim
to
that.
What happened to your eyebrows, girl?
I fall victim to that because I was one of those girls every week faithfully going to the nail salon like, all right, clean me up. Make sure pencil thin. Mm-mm. And you walking around wondering why you always look surprised.
I mean, I like things that I like. I mean, I like, you know, lipstick and I don't really watch nothing else, really. Like, I just like, you know, I just like a clean face, you know? Like, I don't...
What's a clean face? Like, no blemishes without makeup or with makeup?
Like, I don't like when I can tell you got makeup on.
All right, so you want, like, a very, very barely there look.
Yeah.
Okay, that's understandable. A lot of people can't accomplish that, honestly. That's, definitely. Like, the hardest makeup face to do. Because you have to, like, make it seem like you don't have anything on. Meanwhile, you could have a full face.
But see, that's why I get fooled sometimes. Like, you told me, like, when we had that day, we were chilling and we was going through the magazine and we checking out chicks. And I'm like,
that's what I said.
Is that a full face or no face? And I'm like, full face?
Nope.
No, boo boo.
No,
like,
that's a full face, honey. That's what I'm saying. Like, if
it's hit or miss sometimes.
If you can accomplish a barely there face, you are a great makeup artist. That means that you know your foundations, you know your concealers, you know your highlights, your contours, you know how to set properly. That's another thing why I was telling you about a few minutes ago about the foundation and using a setting powder. Like when you take a picture and you see that little white residue on their face. Mm-hmm. So a lot of people be getting these setting powders. It could be a very, very white setting powder. So when they take a picture, it's like, okay, you have something white on your face, but then when the flash
what is that?
Right?
What is that?
When the flash is not there, it's like, okay, she got a regular face. Mm. But when you put that flash on, when you put that flash
on, you put
on,
me onto that.
Boo boo, you know better. You should have mixed your setting powder with some benign powder, the orange one or the red one or the yellow one to make it blend into your undertone. But a lot of people don't do that. Mm. It's a lot of
why stupid. Is that laziness or what?
It's not laziness. You want to know what the honest truth is? A lot of people don't know how to apply certain things. Like, I believe that with makeup, it's easier to learn. Like, you have to learn through trial and error. Like, my mother says that all the time. She's like, your eyebrows are too dark, or your concealer's too light, or your foundation isn't matching. But little do you know, you might have to mix 2-3 foundations to get your exact color.
I think it's a confidence thing with some women. Like,
what, with makeup?
Yeah, definitely.
Honey,
because some chicks don't be... No, but I'm saying, like, some chicks don't need it, you know, and they still want to put it on, I guess, to get the extra attention or whatever.
Nah, you know what I think it is? I think it's a fad. I'm not going to say a fad, but think about it. We're 28, 29 years old, right? Mm-hmm. When we were younger, we really wasn't thinking about makeup or brand names or even these $5,000 shoes people walking around right. with. We wasn't thinking about that.
So wasn't thinking about no booty shots.
Exactly. People wasn't altering their body. Was looking natural. That's
another thing I hate, man.
That's what I'm saying. Now it's becoming a fad. So when they see one person doing it, it's like a follow fashion, as Panamanians would say. Mm. Everybody want to be a follow fashion. When they see one person doing it, the next one want to do it too.
Just love yourself.
But everybody, it's not a matter of not loving yourself. You just want to be accepted. Like, it's a
no,
difference.
But you know what? It's the fella's fault, too. You know what I mean? And let me talk about the butt injections and all that stuff, because I hate that.
Listen, y'all like people, going to the strip club. No, y'all like throwing y'all dollars.
Not
y'all
this guy here.
Money.
Not this man here.
That's the reason why these girls is getting away with things like that.
Listen, I go to the strip club. And if a chick come up to me with a fake ass, she ain't getting no money. And I only pull up to the strip club with about $5. She ain't gonna get my five hard-earned dollars.
$5? That's it? $5?
Look, I had a chick getting tight at me one time because I was like, look, I don't want that. I don't want to. That's fake. Yeah, you but false like, advertising.
That's what I said. I think it's a follow fashion kind of thing. Because if you notice, it wasn't popular to go.
Just like y'all don't want no dude that's out here fronting like he got it.
Listen. If you could finesse it, let me tell you something. That's one thing I learned. If you could finesse it, you could pull something. if you good at finessing, you in there like swimwear. Right? Because a lot of people could put up a facade like, okay, I have all this makeup, my body's done, I got a house, I got a car, I'm looking lit, right? Mm-hmm. But then...
But you single as a dollar.
Right? Going to bed lonely.
Why is that? Are you crazy?
Going to bed lonely. Because at the end of the day, you're not happy with yourself. But this is a more positive show. Let's not even go to the deep end.
Let's not hurt people's feelings.
Right? Now. This is the deep end. This is where we talk about women who do makeup or apply makeup on a daily basis. Not because they don't love themselves, they just like to enhance themselves. Like, I'm not even going to front. I speak for all the women out there. I'm one of the type of women, I have my days. Like, some days I'll be like, all right, I'm pretty, I'm lit today. And other days I'll be like, I'm all right. I could be fine. And then I have my days where I'm like, oh,
I'm
my God.
I'm about to beat it up, bitch.
Right? Oh, my God. Let me go back in the crib because I look ridiculous right now. Oh, but realize God. Those days when I feel like that is when you get the most attention.
Really?
When you feel like crap. Not when you on fleek. Because you ever know, when you notice when you on extra fleeky, like, it's everybody just bypass you. Mm. But then when you feel
Why
like...
Is that?
I have no idea.
Because we don't care for all that makeup. Let me see your natural state.
But people can accept it, though. Honestly.
How you figure?
Honestly. Let's have a real conversation right now. Okay. Honestly. You think somebody can accept you for who you really are. Like, really, really are.
Yeah.
Without no enhancements, without no facade, no physicalities, no nothing. You think somebody could accept all of that?
I accept my girl. My girl don't wear a lot of makeup.
Listen, we not talking about Miss Sabrina right now.
That's real love.
We not talking about Miss Sabrina right now. We talking about, can you really accept somebody?
Yeah, I mean, because, look, you put on all that makeup and then suppose you want to go jump in the pool and then you come up out the
Listen,
pool looking like a Medusa.
Listen, there's waves around that. My makeup could stay on in water, honey.
Oh, man. Now y'all getting advanced.
See,
now.
I told you. It's the way of finesse. You can finesse man. It.
Yeah, y'all getting advanced now with this makeup. This
That's what I'm
era.
Saying. You can't even say, let's go swimming. We can go swimming. Ain't nothing coming up. Probably my lashes. That's it. Mm. Everything else is sealed and delivered.
I'm gonna have to take a towel to the face. Like, well, come here. Let me smear your face.
Sealed and delivered, honey.
Schmear. You remember that?
Yeah, right. But that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't think that people nowadays will accept you for who you really are. Like, if you really...
I disagree.
Really?
Yeah. I think y'all seeking attention from the wrong crowd. The crowd that y'all want that attention from is from the wrong crowd.
What attention but do if you think that
like
is?
You, like you said, when you on your regular day and you getting the most attention... I think those are the type of guys y'all should go with, not the guys that want y'all with all the makeup on and all that. Get you a fella.
Hey, big
wanna,
fella.
Hey, big fella. Get you a fella that want to be with you for you.
That's what I'm saying.
And that could wake up next to you in the morning and be like, hey, boo, give you a little nice kiss on the cheek or whatever, you know?
Okay, but this is what I'm
not
trying to say.
Not nobody to be like, oh,
if what the I hell? Come
yo,
outside,
put your makeup on, man.
If I come outside, no makeup. My hair's not done.
Oh, well, yeah, definitely gotta have the hair done at least.
See? But then you're not accepting me as I am, though. You're not accepting me as I am.
Listen now.
You're not.
I do accept you.
You're
I'm just
not
saying.
Accepting me as I am.
I'm not gonna let you walk outside with your hair all messed up.
No, I'm not saying looking like crazy or nothing like that. I'm saying imagine your girl coming outside, no makeup on. Her hair's not done. She probably got it in a doobie or a little basic ponytail, right? With her hair, no added hair, right? She probably got it on your t-shirt, your sweatpants.
Yo, I'm the wrong one, man.
And some Nike slides.
My girl is a hardcore tomboy, so
but that's what I'm saying.
And
some
one.
Nike slides. It'll be hard.
I'm not real finicky like that.
But that's you. Right. A lot of men don't really like that. A lot of men want to see if
some men like to change their women. Like some women will be. Nah, I agree. I see what you're saying. Like some men will be. You know, they'll say they like natural, but then when they get with the chick, they're like, "Yo,
exactly. Like
get you
I
some
had
makeup
this,
or do this and do that." And I'm
yep,
like,
I had so this I conversation before. I had this conversation with one of my homegirls, one of my best friends. She was telling me that she started talking to this guy. And he was like, "Oh, I like natural beauty, like." Natural. And she was like, do you even know what natural is? He's like, yeah, no makeup, don't put no weave in your hair, you know, dress regular.
Right, that's the basic answer.
But that's not natural.
I want to get all technical.
You know what natural is? Not shaving your legs.
Oh,
not
nah.
shaving
there
your
you
armpits.
No.
Making sure you come out of bed and you fluffing up your hair. You take your little shower. You put on your hippie crystal underneath
your arms. I mean, of course you
got to
clean up. I mean,
you put your hippie
the fellas
got to
get a shape up, and we
got to
shape up our beards too. So y'all got to at least
everything
shave them
vegan.
Underarms and between
everything.
The legs.
Everything is vegan. That's natural. That's a natural woman.
No. See, now you're getting a little too technical.
No. See, this is why I say you got to be careful
know
what
we
you
talking
ask
about.
For.
When we talking about that natural beauty, we talking about no substances applied to the face.
But you have to apply some type of substance in order to have a clean face. In order to have a clean face, you got to use soap and water.
Right.
Okay. Lip gloss is a substance as well.
Yeah.
You like glossy lips? Do you like matte lips? Do you like lipstick or lip stain?
I mean, I like lipstick, like, you know, like the red lips and I like the red lipstick thing.
You like the red lipstick
and,
thing?
Yeah, I like that. And I like the lip gloss. But that's because, you know, Miss Sabrina is not up here, like you said.
Miss Sabrina is not here. Miss Sabrina,
I'm vouching for you, baby.
Right? She's going to have to cut the check because we up here talking about her. But this is what I'm saying. A lot of guys will say they want natural. And then when you ask them who they idolize that is natural, it'll be women that wear the most makeup. Like, I had a conversation with my homeboys the other day, too. They were saying that. I was like, who do you like that you think that don't wear makeup? They pulled out names like Keisha Cole, Cardi B. And,
ew, somebody said Cardi B?
Cardi B.
Oh,
they like Keisha Cole, Cardi B. What's another one that they named? Oh, my God. She's a TV host. Tamar Braxton.
Oh, my God.
Monica.
They wear
Tiana Taylor.
I'm just not like every other dude, I guess, because I already know those chicks wear a lot of makeup.
When you talk about celebrities that wear the minimal makeup, God rest their soul, the first person that would come into my mind is somebody like Aaliyah or somebody like Whitney Houston, right. Even though she did wear a lot of makeup in the beginning.
I got something for you. And fellas, take some notes, man. This I feel this is a lady that is naturally beautiful. Sade.
What? Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, Lord. She is naturally beautiful, and she wears minimal makeup. She
See, probably, that's what I'm talking about right there.
She probably just wears mascara and lipstick, right. And that's it.
That's fine. Like,
and she has her hair pulled back, a little suavemente is pulled back in a nice little tight ponytail.
That's what I'm talking about, natural beauty.
Well, that's not bad. That's not bad. Right. You know, Sade is a diva in her own right. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people don't think like that. You see what I'm saying? Because we're so focused on media idolizing certain people. Like, they glorify, you know, ratchet TV.
Yeah, it's a lot of,
they glorify these strippers.
These TV shows don't help.
Right? They glorify these strippers. They glorify, like, your local hood celebrities. Mm-hmm. No offense to those who are making the money that way. Mm-hmm. However you get your paper is how you get your paper, but...
By all means, get your paper.
Yep, but TV glorifies those people, but... When you in your everyday life, you don't see that. Right. Like, when you home chilling or when you come outside, do you really see a shorty that look like she just came from the strip club or she worked for the strip club? Or she got a body like, oh my God, like, Lord, take the wheel. Like, you don't really see that. You see your basic, normal Keisha from around the way. Mm-hmm. You don't really be seeing that. So that's what getting me confused. And I'm like, okay. Men will say that they want those type of females,
right?
But then we'll go for
the chicks put all the makeup on, huh?
Right.
I got another example. A chick like what's her name? And I know she wears makeup, but I feel like without the makeup, she's pretty. And I'm just going because you know she got a nice face. So I just sometimes like when I know they have makeup on, I try to like. Take the makeup off visually and try to picture how they would look. Because let me tell you, man, I be on YouTube sometimes. I've come across a YouTube video in the past where it was this chick. I mean, God, I guess God did not take his time on her or whatever.
Oh my God.
So, you know, and she had a lot of stuff on her face, whatever, blah, blah, blah. But she put on like a bunch of makeup. And then by the time it was over, she looked like a totally different person. That's what scares the fellas when they see stuff like that.
All right. See, there's a difference. I feel two ways about that, honestly. When I see somebody applying
that's
makeup...
That's being lied to.
Yeah, but when I see somebody applying makeup, like, overly putting too much application on,
right.
Like, too much concealer, too much foundation, that's, to me, they're just learning how to do makeup. Because some people, I've noticed, like, even with my journey with makeup, in the beginning, I was very heavy-handed. Mm-hmm. Like, I would cake on makeup, and I'm like, okay, I need this. And then when you start getting to the swing of things, you're like, I don't really need all of this. I just need a little bit here, a little bit there. Like today, I just dabbed it on and came out because I was like, this don't need that much effort. I'm not doing nothing special today. But then I've came across some YouTubers... Even some people I've seen on WeTV, like this one girl, like it honestly made me cry. She was like a burn victim, and it also was a cancer.
I think I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it was a burn victim and a cancer victim. Both of them, they didn't have not that much really much color to them, especially the cancer victim.
Right.
She must have had just went through dialysis or something like that because her skin was all flushed. She didn't have no hair. But the person that was applying makeup for her birthday, of course.
Made her look like A1.
Not saying that she was ugly or anything like
no,
that.
No, but she probably was already pretty, but because she has, you know, those effects.
She was very, very... She was even pretty without it.
Right.
Even with a bald head and everything, she was very, very beautiful. Mm-hmm. But when
I think I know what you're talking about.
Yep, but
that was a pretty girl.
Yep, when they applied the makeup, I'm like, oh my God, she looks so gorgeous. Mm-hmm. But some people fall victim to certain life circumstances where they might need makeup. Because society...
Oh, well, see, that's understandable. But when some chicks don't really need it, I'm like... You know what I mean? Like, say we in a relationship and we got to go somewhere. I'm like, come on, woman, really? You really got to do this right now?
Listen.
You going to wake us late.
Mommy be complaining with me about that all the time. She's like, we only going to the grocery store. You got to put on makeup. Listen, you don't know when I'm going to meet my Prince Akeem. Oh, I got to be A1 all the time.
Oh, Lord.
I could be just going to the gas station. I got to apply something. At least some eyebrows and some mascara and some eyeliner.
Oh, yeah. So, the girl I was trying to talk about that probably wears a lot of makeup. Mm-hmm. But I feel like she's very pretty. Is that girl that was in that movie with... What is that movie? Where they was working for NASA?
Hidden Figures?
Yeah.
Who? Janelle Monáe?
Yeah, Janelle Monáe.
She wears a full face, honey.
I know. I could tell she wears makeup a lot. Mm-hmm. But I feel like without makeup,
she's still beautiful.
Pretty. Very pretty.
She's pretty. Even,
that's what I'm talking
even
about.
Even without makeup, she's pretty. Right. Even the rest of the women, like Octavia Spencer, she's beautiful.
See, like stuff like that, I'll get mad about. Like, why are you wearing all this makeup?
Listen, that's what I said. In today's society, to be accepted, especially if you're in the public eye, you need to wear makeup. You have to.
Well, that's understandable, too.
That's in the budget.
That's
in your budget.
Guess, so.
Exactly. That's in your budget. You have to have makeup on, especially if you're doing red carpet events, if you're doing photo shoots, if you're doing movies, even on-set videos.
But when you're a regular Keisha on the block.
Right? Keisha just need her eyebrows did.
Well, maybe a little lipstick or something.
A little bit of lip gloss.
Lip gloss. Don't come out with chappy lips looking like
right,
that chick
her
from
little
Black
eyeliner, and she done. that's real, real basic and
yeah,
real, real minimal.
Keep it basic, man. Not
I
too
don't
much.
Think people really want to keep it basic. I think, like, for special occasions, you want to just go.
That's cool. Ain't nothing
a
wrong
little
with that.
Dramatic.
But when, well, I'm talking about, like, when chick do it religiously, like, every day.
Nah. You gotta switch it up. And that's what I noticed with me. I have my full face days. I have my partial face days. I have my days when I'm extra lit. Like, lit.
That's cool. Ain't cool.
But that's when I'm going out.
When some chicks is coming out every day like that. So, would you have, like, any like, suggestions on some ladies or advice
when it comes to makeup? My suggestion when it comes to makeup is be conscious about your mixing, be conscious about your blending, be conscious about certain makeup products. Oh yeah, and another thing, when you're first starting out with your makeup, you don't necessarily have to go out and buy every product that you see,
right?
Or that you see these YouTubers, they it takes time to develop a professional case, even if you're not doing a professional case to be a makeup artist, but you're doing a professional case for yourself. Mm. You don't need certain things. Like, I used to OD. When I say OD, I used to OD. Like, I need this product. I need that product. I got to use this product on my face. I got to use this product to blend it in. I need 5011 brushes. Like, you really don't need that, honestly. A regular makeup artist may say, okay, I need a blending brush. I need a concealing brush. I need a contouring and highlighting brush. Of course, you need a little spoolie to do your eyebrows and stuff like that, and your lip brush, and that's it. Mm. Honestly, out of all them brushes, you're probably going to use 3 consistently. 3. I remember one time I was balling. I had my little money. I spent like $600 in Sephora.
Oh, my Lord.
$600 in Sephora. Mind you, don't get it twisted. Like, I use all of those products, but a lot of those products that I bought, I probably used probably...
Them shits better last you for 2 years.
That's the thing. A lot of those products that you buy, you really don't really need it. Basically, on an everyday basis, as my advice, what you're going to need on an everyday thing is, like I said, work on your blending, work on your mixing, work on your concealing, like, play with colors. Because I guarantee you, no one company has your one foundation. Right now, my foundation routine, I use about 3 different foundations from 3 different companies to get my perfect shade. So it looks like it blends in properly.
It looks like you.
Exactly. My neck, my chest, my face, my hands, everything match.
Ladies, at least if you're going to put on the full face, at least make sure you get that neck.
Yes, make sure you make sure.
Because you're looking like...
You have to make sure. That's the only thing I could stress. Like, make sure.
Like,
you
some chicks
blend.
Be doing it just to the chin, and you can see underneath their chin, and be like, what happened to the
that's
rest
what I'm
of
saying.
It?
You gotta
like
blend, baby. You have to blend. Make sure you blend and conceal. You have to blend and conceal. If you, all right, I feel sorry. I'm not going to say I feel sorry, but certain women have hyperpigmentation. You know, hyperpigmentation is like dark spots. Their neck might be hyperpigmented, like really, really dark. Or under their eyes might be really, really dark. Or like certain spaces in their face might be really, really dark. Maybe from a scar or from acne or from whatever. That's what you need a good concealer for. I remember watching this girl. She asked me to help her do her makeup. Of course, I helped her. But she picked up a concealer that was like 5 shades lighter than her regular skin to cover up her hyperpigmentation. I'm like, honey, you don't need to go that light. Like, you could go, you could do your say, your exact shade to cover that.
Some chicks need a real honest friend in their pack to let them know when to stop.
Listen, I've done seen a lot of things. I've seen a lot. And I'm not going front like I'm perfect because I have my days where I'm like, oh no, I got to wash all this off and do it over.
You already know me. I don't be holding back. Cuz I'll be like, Cuzzo.
Listen, I have my days. I have my days. And I notice when I rush is when I have days like that. When it's like,
gotta take your time, do it right.
And you have to, and that's the thing. Like, to me, applying makeup is like when you go into the gym. If you are a religious person going to the gym every day, maybe 2-3 times a day, that's how makeup is. You have to, like, get into the swing of it, like, get into used to doing it every day. Because I notice a lot of people, they be ragging on me, like, oh, how can you put makeup on every day? Because I'm used to it by now.
I got another question. So, you know, being that you are a makeup artist, right? Or being that you're a makeup artist, and say maybe you're dealing with a chick that don't really put on makeup like that. How would you apply makeup to them? Would you, like, make them look totally different? Or would you, like, what would you do?
No. See, my goal as a makeup artist is to never make you look different. You're going to look the same.
Right.
You're just going to look enhanced. That's how I put it. Like, to me, like I said, I will never call nobody ugly. I will never call nobody, you know, out of their name or whatever. But if you have certain issues with your face or certain issues, like, I'll give you one story. I ran into this one lady. She's an older lady. She wanted me to do her makeup for her retirement party. Face was a little bit dark on one side, but she had like a slight little blemish on the right side of her face, and she had like a little scar. And it was like dark around the scar. She had dark under her eyes. And I told her, I was like, she's like, oh my God, I don't think you're going to be able to cover it with makeup. I said, the goal is not to cover it. The goal is to make it look like you have, it's all one. It's blended in. So she's like, I don't want so much makeup on. Don't make it so cakey. Because I see a lot of girls who put so much makeup on. And then I'm going to a party. I don't want my face to run. I said, honey, don't worry. Your face is not going to run. I got you. Just let me break my magic. I did her makeup. She didn't come out no different. Her skin tone was even. Her concealer was even. Her foundation was applied properly. Her highlight contour was on 10. Her eyebrows was on fleek. Her eyeshadow, everything was extra lit. She was on a honey. The Slayer's savagery was on 1,000 when I was done with her. You hear me?
I hear you, cousin.
So when I saw her, she's like, oh my gosh. She's like, you gotta do my makeup all the time. I love this. Like, you didn't apply too much makeup, you know, because the last makeup artist I went to, she applied so much makeup and she ended up having 5 shades lighter than my normal skin. So I'm like, because she probably didn't know how to blend. That's the thing. You gotta play around with foundation. That's why I keep saying you gotta stress. Blend. Play around with foundation colors. Play around with concealers to get your perfect skin tone. That's the most important thing. You can mess up on your eyeshadow. You can mess up on blending your eyebrows out.
Ken, don't mess up on nothing else, please.
But you got to make sure your foundation color is A1. Your concealer is A1.
That's all I'm saying. Like, don't have two-tone skins out here, you know? Don't be looking crazy.
But that's what I'm saying. You can't get upset with certain people if they're foundation.
If they're not experienced, I guess?
Yeah, because it's something that they have to learn. Especially if they don't want to be a makeup artist. Like, if they just
doing
it.
My thing is, don't they look in the mirror before they walk?
Of course. That's the next thing. You have to have great lighting. You have to have great lighting. Because I know this. I fall victim to that, too. Sometimes I could put on makeup when the light's not even on. Mm. Like, if it's sunny outside, of course, the way my room is set up, my makeup table...
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, my makeup table is right next to the window. So I don't turn on the light. I use a natural light.
Right.
But as soon as I go into my vanity area and I turn on the lights, I'm like, okay, I put on too much hair. Let me tone it down a little bit here. Mm. That's the next thing. Like, you have to have great lighting.
Yeah, I see. You told me about that lighting. Because, you know, some people, when they take the picture with the flash, the makeup looks different and all that.
All of that. You have to be careful of fluorescent lighting. Like, if you have mood lighting, it's a game. Like, you tricking yourself. You're like, all right, I'm lit. But then when you go on fluorescent
when you
lighting...
When step outside looking right? like Dorky the Clown.
When you go on fluorescent lighting...
Boy,
like,
if you don't get...
You have to be like, oh, no. Let me go back in the house. Let me fix this real quick.
But, get your ass in the house, big fella.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you have to make sure. You have to make sure. You got to make sure. Another thing I wanted to ask you was, what do you think about women... who want to be a makeup artist, like, as a profession?
As profession.
As a profession. So that means you have to accept her as a makeup artist, meaning that she's going to have a made-up face practically 90% of the time.
Okay, so what are you asking this question as opposed to if I had a girlfriend that was like that, or are you just saying in general?
Yeah, like a spouse or a friend or a family member. Or anything like that, like a person that's a professional makeup artist.
All right, but now before I answer that question, I have another question. So if a chick is doing that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why does she have to have the makeup on? And now I'm just using my head now. I'm assuming because she would have to have makeup on herself, I guess, to show.
Yes, you have to sell your product. Hello, this is like a drug transaction. If you see me. And you know
but
I got
if you
the...
know you're gonna beat it up nice.
Nah, listen. If you see you gotta... me, if you see me, and you know I got the best product around.
Right.
Right? Because you see me with the product.
Right.
You see my customers.
But hold on now,
the
big
product.
Hold on now, big fella. If you wanna talk about that kind of stuff, the dealers don't be trying. You can't be using your own stuff now. You can't
never
be getting
get high
on
your
supply.
Own supply. That's right. That's right. But you still have to get baited in somehow. You know how many times that I've had my makeup done on Fleek and a lot of people will stop me like, oh my God, who did your eyebrows or who did your makeup? Oh, and I passed them my business card. Okay. That's how you have to sell your product. That's like a hairdresser
or a
barber.
Okay, but I'm saying if you're already established and you got your spot where chicks is coming in to, you know, get beat up, as they would say nowadays, to get beat. You know, why would you have to have on the makeup if you already know you qualify for the job to
but
get the job
done?
But this is the
thing.
You know
have
saying?
To. Only way
I guess to get them a boost of confidence to trust in.
Only way I could see that work? Happening. Only way I could see that happening where I don't have to wear makeup and you already know my quality of work.
That's what I'm saying.
The only way I could see that is if my name ring bells out here.
Okay. So your name has to ring bells.
It
before
gotta
you
ring
can...
bells. You gotta be like. Oh, I know Tickness. Like, her makeup is lit. I don't even got to question her character. I don't got to question her portfolio. I got to question her because I already seen. Right. She's already out here doing things. She's posting. She's on Instagram. She's got social media. She got everything lit. It's lit. I don't got to question her about nothing.
I see what you're saying. So, but back to your question now. I would fully support that.
Yeah, but...
That's where the money is now. Everybody's doing that, so...
But I've heard...
Get you a piece of that pie.
This is what I've heard. What
What did you hear?
Makeup is over a $40 billion industry.
That's a lot of money.
$40 billion. With a B. B. Billion dollar industry. Right? And it's a female-dominated industry. But now, more recently, it's becoming a male-dominated industry.
Yeah, because, you know, you get a lot of...
Right? But the problem that I have with that is the melanated group is only 5%. Mm-hmm. So the other 95% is the other people. Not saying that that's a bad thing.
We don't want to offend nobody.
Yeah, that's not saying that that's a bad thing.
It's a very offensive age we're living
right?
in.
Right? It's not saying that that's a bad thing, but only 5% are melanated or people of color. Like, It's enough room. I always say that. It's enough room for everybody. It's enough room
to get a slice.
Exactly.
But somebody got to start somewhere. I guess, you know, we got to work together on
that's
that,
my
know?
Problem. Like, I've done my research on how to establish a business, become a professional makeup artist, building my portfolio, building a brand for yourself. And then when you go through the research and you saying, okay, well, I need to do X, Y, and Z in order to become established. And then when you follow those rules, it's like the door's still closed. So now you got to find another route. Then when you find another route, you found 50, 11 other people that took that same route. And they struggling to get in just like you. But meanwhile, homegirl across the pond only put up one video, maybe have two or three people as a portfolio. Now she's a professional makeup artist. Getting flown across the world, working with multiple different people.
It's not what you know.
It's who you know.
It's who you know.
But that's the thing. With makeup, is very, very scarce. Like, especially if you, like me, I want to become a brand by myself without a professional brand backing me. Like, I want to get my foot in the door to be known as an individual, not be powered by a machine.
I don't understand how that would work, though. Like, wouldn't you have to have your own products?
Of course. It's easy to make your own products. It's easy to make your own, you know, your own products, your own labeling, your own packaging, stuff like that. That's easy. That's the easy part. The hard part is getting your foot in the door to be recognized. Because now I'm an ant amongst giants.
Right.
You got the big name people. Big names, makeup artists, makeup companies, all of that.
Right.
So now makeup is blended into the beauty world. So you got, you know, beauty is a $1 billion industry too. You have hair, you got hair products, you got waxing, right? You even got barbery for men. You got extensions.
Oh my God, let's not talk about
you got
the men.
Nail. You got the nail people. You got nail technicians. You got pedicurists. You got all of that.
Since you said men, I got a question for you now.
Another
question, big fella.
Hey, big fella.
What about men that's out here putting on this? They spraying their hair back on.
Listen.
How y'all feel about that?
If you are going bald, baby, let it go. Let
Thank
it
you.
Go.
Come on home like I did, man. You know,
let this. It go. There's a difference, though. I saw a video on Instagram of these guys getting
See how y'all feel about that, ladies?
Listen, when I see that, you can't tell me nothing about no weave. You can't tell me nothing about.
But would y'all accept a dude like that?
Listen, if it's for.
How y'all gonna feel?
No, hold on.
How y'all gonna feel now when dude got the? Y'all think his hairline is sharp? His beard is extra crisp, and then y'all go and do y'all little thing, and then
listen,
all of a sudden you roll over.
Listen,
and his thing is leaking off his face.
Listen,
and he got all
missing
spots.
Listen, I support you.
Yo, this age is different.
Listen, I'm speaking about me. I will support you for whatever you want to do, right? If it's a medical reason why you losing your hair.
No, it's a confidence reason.
Some dudes
don't really like to go bald.
Listen,
it took me a minute before
listen,
I actually went bald.
You have alopecia.
I was trying to hold on. You know?
That's what I'm saying. Alopecia. You got male pattern baldness.
Oh,
you got, God forbid, cancer. Or some type
of... Yeah, I was looking like a cancer patient.
Listen,
out there for a while.
Listen, I accept it. If you want to enhance yourself because you cannot let that hair go, at least don't spray it on. You know what I'm saying? Spend your little coins. Get you a barber that know how to, you know, glue it up right. Put the little hair on. Shape you
shame.
Up nice.
It's a damn shame what's become of these men.
Listen... I am a big fan of men grooming themselves. Like, if you could shape up your beard nice, you know, tape up your lineup, your haircut is on fleek.
If you got hair, yeah.
Yeah.
If your hair is on fleek.
But if you bald, own it, honey. Confidence is key. But once I see you spraying on your little hair, or if I see you getting your little tracks glued in, if I see that, you cannot tell me nothing.
Oh,
you can't tell me nothing about... Oh, why you got all this tracks in your hair? You got a weave and you spend it. Don't tell me nothing about that because you getting it too. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it at all. That's just me. But I saw that. And even about, I'm seeing men too that's put applying makeup. Like men that wear makeup.
Oh, Lord.
No, but even your big name actors wear makeup. Did you know that?
Yeah, I be seeing them. They be in these little trailers and I guess, but it's not. But see, it's not heavy makeup.
It's not heavy. It's just to even them out. It's not that bad. But then I'm seeing some men, like, they're applying.
Some men is getting a little extra.
Yeah, they putting on lashes.
Make you think.
Eyeshadow. Eyebrows is on extra fleek.
I mean, well, this is the age we're in now, so. But I feel like the roles
do you have a problem with that? Like, I accept it. I think it's fun. I think it's fun. If that's what you do. And when I say that's
if
what you
I
do.
If I accept it?
If that's what you do, I mean like this.
I know what you mean. I don't accept that at all. Because.
Why?
I'm for the ladies. I ain't looking at no dudes.
Listen. You gotta get it how you live.
The dudes is what I'm concerned about.
You gotta get it how you live. You gotta do it one time for the one time.
I think these dudes out here need some. They need some masculine shots, man, because they some testosterone shots, as I would say.
Listen,
because they
I feel that men already, you know what?
Men, we looking bad out here, man.
I don't think men is looking bad at all. You know what I think it is? I think that some men, you know, I'm gonna be brutally honest. I feel that some men, whether confident or not. In some sort of part of their life, they wasn't as confident. So now,
I think everybody's like that, though.
Yeah, but now that they at the age to do something about it, they gonna go all out.
Yeah, well,
that's like if you never had money in your life, and all of a sudden you come into a big sum of money, you gonna floss because you ain't never had it before.
This is the age we're in now. I mean, you can get anything fixed now. I'm like, I'm hearing chicks is getting. Matter of fact, what's funny, I just seen a commercial today. there's a doctor out there. He got a commercial for, I guess, for people, women with bow leg or whatever they call that thing.
They're getting it or they're
No, they're fixing it. So like, he's taking the fat out the back or whatever and shooting it in the calf so they don't look like
what
they're bow legged. And I'm like,
but bow legged is cute though.
That's what I'm saying. You get your little knee along on.
What?
Come on, man. Love you. I don't like when people be doing that, man. They be
This is what brings me to say this. That a lot of people cannot accept people for who they really are. Right? I'm going to let you in on a little secret. My little accident that I had in 2011, you know, I was in the hospital for a couple of months. And I had to have this hip surgery. And the doctor told me, oh, you will never walk again. All this other stuff. You will forever have a limp and all this other stuff. That kind of stuff brings you down. Like, you would be like, oh, my God, I was so confident before, but now I'm not confident now. So you like, who's going to accept me for that? Like, you got to put on the front, like, oh my God, I gotta be lit every time I go outside now. Like, just to take the attention off of whatever you're masking or whatever you're hiding. Right? I never forget one time, I think this is when I had just got off of crutches and I was starting to walk by myself without the crutches. And this guy was like, why you walking so funny? Like a random person. I ain't know him from nowhere. He was like, why you walking so funny? And I just looked at him. I'm like, I gave him this dead look like... Why are you so nosy? Like, why you need to know what's wrong with me? Like, worry about yourself. But then I had to sit down and realize that I thought it was something wrong with me. But if you're not confident in yourself, like...
Well, maybe he was interested and he really wanted to know what was going on.
Yeah, but that's the wrong way to go about it. That's the wrong way. That's like me walking up to you like, yo, bro, why your nose so big? Like, like, dead ass. Why is it so big? Like, was you born that way?
I'd be like, God made it that way. So what you want me to do?
But this is what I'm saying. Like, certain things like that could tip people off. Like, oh my God, I need to get my nose done. Yeah. I need to get this done. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, even now, that's why I say I fall victim to that now. Because my scar is about 16 inches long.
You need somebody that's going to kiss them scars.
Listen, to find somebody like that nowadays is a rock in a hard place.
I don't think it's that hard.
So that's why I be like, you know what? I'm going to get this tatted up because that's my little confidence thing.
That's another thing, too. A lot of chicks is getting stuff tatted up.
You got to cover them scars.
I'm on to y'all. I'm on to y'all,
ladies. You
got to
cover them scars, boo-boo. You have to cover them scars. Man. That's why I be saying, like...
They be getting their little injections or whatever, and then they want to...
Yeah, cover it with a scar.
You're already giving it away. I already
cover
know
your scar. About. But that's what I'm saying. Like, people are conscious about that. Like me, I'm very conscious about my scar. Mm. So when I see it, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get a tattoo to cover this up so it don't look so obvious. Mm. Right? But then, you know, my mother, she's like, you should leave it. Don't cover that scar. That's your warrior wound. Wear it proudly. Right. But then when you around people that don't know you, for instance, if we're at a beach or mm-hmm. if we're somewhere where I'm wearing shorts and people see, like, oh my God, what happened? Are you okay? Like, what's the matter?
Right.
Like, you don't want to be bombarded with questions like that. So you just be like, oh, I had
to. You like attention, but you don't like the wrong attention sometimes.
I don't like attention, period. That's just me. I don't like nosy people. You know me already. My mouth is reckless.
No, it's an Edwards thing.
Exactly. Like, we don't give a goddamn. We just want to be about our business right. and keep it pushing. Be low-key as possible.
Right.
But people don't like that. They want to know. But that's just people's curiosity. You can't really fight or fault somebody for that. But that's why I say, like, you know what it is? Everybody just has to love themselves for who they are. Not saying that you don't love yourself, but you gotta love yourself a little more. Like, not everybody is meant to look like the top stripper in the club or the video vixen or look like Tay Diggs or Cam Newton. Like, nobody is meant to look like that. It's right. They look like that because they look like that. If right. you look different, that's what makes you unique. Like, imagine now if all these females look the same and all these dudes look the same.
I'll be trying to imagine if all these females ain't wearing no makeup.
Listen, all of us will look so different. But then when everybody looks the same, it's like, okay, I don't really have to choose nothing. I can just have all. Because all of y'all look the same. Right? So,
Well, why would everybody look the same? You keep saying the same. Why would everybody look the
when
same?
When I say look the same, I'm like, if you see women with makeup, like, imagine everyone is on fleek. Not saying that.
I mean, because, you know, I'd be on the club scene. And to me, I feel like everybody looks the same when everybody's face is beat.
Listen.
Depending on how, because again, sometimes I can't tell the full face.
That's what I'm saying.
From blase
you
blah.
Have to be yeah. extra unique. That's why I said if you could master the barely there face, mm-hmm. you are a master.
So is that something hard that a lot of women?
It's very hard to do. Like, it's very hard to master a barely there face. Like I said before, if you don't know your foundations properly, if you don't know your concealers, you don't know how to do your blending. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. Blending, and concealing is 95% of your makeup work. 95. But you could get exotic with the eyes. You go crazy with the eyes. You go crazy with the brows even. Because now I'm seeing this new thing now with glitter eyebrows. They got glitter. They got glitter eyeshadow now. There's this fad that just came in. Well, it didn't just came in, but everybody seemed to do it. The cut crease where
the chinky eyes where yeah. they got the damn Cleopatra shit.
Yep, it looks Egyptian-esque. But that's the new fad now. Now
you Jamaican, you ain't from Ethiopia.
Right, you from Flatbush. Dirty Brooklyn. But this is what I'm saying, like, If everybody is continuously doing the same thing, what makes you unique? You get what I'm saying? Like, everybody's gonna look the same. Like, nobody's doing things outside of that. Like, okay, I can understand if you wanna follow the trend.
Let me ask you, do you have a plan on, like, being that you're a makeup artist, do you have a plan on trying to make yourself stand out?
Of course.
How would you see yourself standing out?
I try to follow the trend, but add my own uniqueness to it.
Would you put your own touch on it?
Exactly. Like, I'm throwing this out there, so if anybody want to take my idea, make sure you at me, tweet me, follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube. Just, that's a plug. But if you take this idea, like, if you're going to do a cut crease, why not do a cut crease and add rhinestones instead of using glitter? Mm. Or if you're going to do glitter eyebrows, why not do a ombre glitter eyebrow? Or if you're going to do highlight and contour...
I'm like, I don't know what none of them terms mean.
This is what I'm saying. If you wanna do, if you wanna do like a Egyptian esque thing where you're doing a cut crease or you're doing like an extreme eyeliner or extreme lashes, why not do an outrageous color that nobody do? Here's the deal right now. If you could do a cut crease or any type of makeup and then apply neon colors and you could see the neon colors, that's different. Even though it's bold and it's out there, that's different because everybody's using the same thing. Using neutral colors, using purples, using browns, using blues, using blacks, whites, silvers. You're not really using like crazy colors like pink, red, yellow, green. Like nobody's using those kind of colors. Everybody's using the basic earth tone colors.
What would be your advice for the fellas to tell a lady's full face or what?
Listen, my advice for the fellas would be, if you like makeup, right? If you love makeup, just accept shorty for makeup.
How about the guys that don't like makeup? When they don't want to keep falling for the chicks that look like they, you know, the chicks that got the barely there face, but they got a full face, you know? A guy like me.
Listen.
That seems to always keep falling for...
The best way, I'm letting you into girl code. And those, our listeners, girl code. The best way to tell if somebody has a full face. Compare their face to her neck, her chest, and her hands. Not the inside of her hands, the outside. If all three of those blend and they're the same color, and you can't tell that shorty got on makeup, she lit. But if you see that and she's the colors is off, she need help. And if you see that now, don't embarrass her and be like, yo, you gotta go back in there and fix that
I'm
up.
I'm gonna just be like, yo, you need to go holler at my cousin.
You could do that too. But just in case if I'm not around, just tell her like, baby, you need to blend it in a little bit. Like, Just tell her, blend it in a little bit.
Well, the fellas can say that because I will probably get smacked in the back of my head.
Right? No, listen. Dude, you got to come up to her behind her, say it in a whisper in her ear like, right, babe, you need to blend that in a little bit. And then just give her a kiss on the cheek like, you still sexy though. Just say that. Just be like, you need to blend it in a little bit. Just be like, babe, you still sexy regardless, but... Blend it in. You missed a spot right here.
A little feeling's gonna be hurt.
No, it's not. If you say it like that, she gonna be like, thank you. Like, me, I wouldn't take offense to that. I've been in a relationship where my ex would tell me, like...
No, I thought you were saying as if a gentleman
if you're not with this girl and you see that she needs a little bit of help, just be like, you're very beautiful.
Obviously, if you with a girl, you want her to be
right.
Like,
hey. But if you don't know her now, listen, I can't. I don't want to tell you something and then you get slapped.
Oh no, I'm not. Trust me, I ain't even messing around.
This is the best way.
I'm trying to help the fellas out.
That's what I'm saying. If you don't know her, the best way to do it is like walk up to her politely, say start off with this. I think you're very beautiful. Your makeup is on. It's all right today. You're very, very pretty. But you need to blend it in just a little bit. And just say, have a good day. And just walk away.
You hear that, fellas?
Right? Just walk away. Don't say nothing crazy. That's what I'm saying. Don't say nothing crazy.
Told y'all, gotcha.
That's what I'm saying. Don't say nothing crazy. Because if you get off the wall, shorty would be like, what? Like, she'd be ready to fight. You know how Flatbush girls is. Like, we lit 24/7. So you got to approach her softly. Like, you look very beautiful. You're a very beautiful woman, but you just needed to blend it in a little bit. But you still sexy though.
About to be out here all summer using that line.
Right?
Like, you still jotting it down.
Right? You still sexy though. You still sexy. And then just hit her with the one time. Just be like, all right, I'll see you later. And just walk off. Don't stand there. Because if you stand there, you're giving her time to formulate a reaction. And she's going to curse you out. So I don't want you to say nothing, anything crazy. But do you have any questions? Any other questions for me, cuzzo?
No, that's about it. I ain't really got too much.
All right.
Questions on the makeup topic. You know, you told me everything I needed to know.
Right? So, we let you on a little insight of the girl code. But again, thank you, cuzzo, for coming out tonight. Thank you to my new listeners. Thank you for this podcast. Thank you for attending. I'll see y'all later. Don't forget to subscribe. Love you guys.